After winning NHRA Top Fuel Championships in 2004 and 2005, giving him three overall, Tony Schumacher entered the 2006 season in position to equal Joe Amato's record of three consecutive Top Fuel World Championships. As the season wound down, heading into the final race of the year, the Auto Club Finals in Pomona, California, Schumacher trailed points leader Doug Coletta by slightly more than two rounds of racing, 45 points. Both drivers advanced through the first two rounds of eliminations, but Coletta, hoping to win his first career Top Fuel Championship and had qualified number one, was upset by Schumacher's teammate Melanie Troxell in the semifinals.
Get into the final round now, and Tony Schumacher has got to do what everybody thinks is basically impossible. He has to win the race, has to set the record. Now, we have these rules that say if you're going to set the record, you have to back it up within 1%. Well, you got a backup run earlier, so you know what the record is. He was the record holder at the time. The record's been on the books now for the better part of a year. And he goes into this final round, and I will never forget this. I'm sitting in the tower going, he could run too quick. I mean, he can make a run here that is going to be faster than the 1% backup. I'm going to have to explain to everybody that he's made the quickest run in history, won the race, and Doug Coletta wins the championship because of this 1% rule.
They're set. Tony Schumacher wins the race, runs 4:42, sets the national record. And Tony Schumacher completes one of the most astounding comebacks in drag racing history.
In what has now been called the run, with Schumacher facing Troxell in the final, Tony charged to the victory with an elapsed time of 4.428 seconds, setting a new national record, winning his fourth career world championship, and writing the final chapter of one of the greatest comebacks in drag racing history.
You know, it's one of those things. I mean, the Schumacher and Allen, they put a good run together, and you know, and we got beat. You know, it was not much more than that. You know, you can say about it that we had different opportunities for the outcome to be different, and it wasn't our day.
We didn't just have to go out and run fast. We had to run within a window. We had already set the backup, which never happens. You go out normally, you set the record Friday night, and you got to find a backup within all the rest of the runs. Well, we had made a backup within that 1%. So now we could run faster, a world record, but not go faster than 1%. It had to be such a tiny window. It'd be like telling Sosa, I want you to hit the ball into left field, 430 to 444 yards into that seat. Oh, by the way, bottom of the ninth, bases loaded, World Series. It wasn't just one thing, it was everything. It had to be perfect, and that's how Allen put it. We're either going to do it or not. There's not an in-between. It's gotta be absolutely the best run in the history of the sport. We gave it to him.